So, is my screen visible to you, all of you people? Yeah. So, hello everyone. Good morning. I'm extremely grateful to be part of this SAN talk show today and share my thoughts, experiences, and innovation ongoing in agriculture sector of Nepal. Thank you for creating this platform and inviting me as a research person for the first person for the second session of this webinar. And so briefly to introduce myself, I'm Kiran Timesina, an agriculture graduate from Agriculture and Forestry University and incoming graduate student at Texas A&M University. And I'm currently working as an agri analytics officer at Ghampur, Nepal. Here in Ghampur, I'm applying my learning from the university to create sustainable solution packages to address the various needs of our smallholder farmers in Nepal for establishing the resilient agriculture system in Nepal. So today I will be using this platform to share my experiences and thoughts on digital agriculture, the future of farming in Nepal with reference to the agri innovations ongoing at Ghampur, Nepal and impacts we are creating. Let me begin. I will try to make it short and simple and hope there will be no interruption with the network and power supply at my place. So let's take a look how farming technology has changed over the last centuries and how has technology changed our farming practices. We have come a long way from agriculture version 1 to version 4. Since having animals as our main source of power to haul the objects up to data-driven precision farming, during the era of industrial revolution, the invention of internal combustion engine has set the agriculture industry in motion. People invented something as simple as tractor to perform numerous jobs and with different attachments, as well as something as complicated as the combine built to completely overhaul job for carrying multi-tasks simultaneously. The agriculture technologies advanced rapidly in the second half of the 20th century and at the beginning of the 21st century. This development forever changed the way how farmers work. During 1982, during the time when the need of food was constantly increasing, scientists found a way to genetically modify the plant cell by introducing the agrobacterium, which is still used today for modifying
like any mobile
to produce the yield required for the present world. And in 1994, I think it was the first time where the farmers became able to use the satellite technology to see their farms overhead, allowing for a better tracking and implement the advanced planning for managing the agriculture production. As the penetration of the mobile increased during 2000, in case of Nepal also, the innovation was developed to connect farmers in the field and market where they were able to access to data for procuring agri inputs. Now onwards, after 2015, the technology and digitization with Internet of Things, big data, artificial intelligence, blockchain technology, they have enabled farmers to make a decision based on the information they have on hand. And this has helped producers to harness the power of information to make better informed decisions that allow them to use resources more sustainably. Let's not talk big, let us be awake from the fantasies happening around us with the developed countries and peek on the ground reality of our agriculture system, because the agriculture system can be made more complex when you talk about the digitization. The Nepalese agriculture system is struggling hard to meet the demand of agriculture goods required for the country, where about 2.7 million rural smallholder farmers, and this count is increasing because of the land fragmentation and rural migrants. These farmers hardly produce to sustain their annual requirements. And needless to say, the media is loud about the delay procurement of fertilizers in Nepal at this recent time. About more than 70% of our producers do not have an easy access to quality agri inputs. And that includes the reliable irrigation and quality agri inputs like seeds, fertilizers, etc. And it has been estimated there will be reduction in yield by at least 8% because of the ongoing climate change, global warming, and other climatic catastrophes. And our farmers are already encountering the climate catastrophes related hazards, such as drought, irregular rainfall, erratic rainfall. And this may also affect the not only agriculture, this may also affect the livestock enterprises in Nepal as well, also in the global. And one of the major problems that our agriculture sector is entangled and produce distress among new producers who want to venture into the commercial farming is the intervention of the middleman who floods the Nepalese agriculture market with imported agri items from India. And customer who have to pay, we need to pay about 50 to 300% more than what first-hand buyers pay to farmers. That is the actual cost what the producer get of their produce. And this was found from a research from Gampal during the first lockdown because of the pandemic. We researched on our in customers and we found that the price gap between how much the producer receive and how much we pay, it is about 50 to 300% gap. And as well as in Nepal, one agri technicians, that may be JTA or agri experts like us who have completed bachelor, one agri technician is responsible to look after about 1500 farmers. And we all know the ground reality, how our farmers get access to them. In the developed countries, one technician looks after about 400 farmers. And the evergreen points to be made, our farmers rely on the traditional methods. And this we have been saying since decades. And methods of farming and our productivity is very lower. This is the actual ground reality of our producers. Which is trending in media, which is on trend on media nowadays. The delay procurement of urea fertilizer, which will severely impact the national production of paddy and other crops that eventually affects the economic growth rate of Nepal. And at this time of pandemic, farmers are queuing to get a kilo of fertilizers. And you know, the quality of these fertilizers and how farmers applied those fertilizers in the field. A recent research from Gampal, where we tested different fertilizer samples available in different aggregates of Kathmandu for validating the Gampal Kishi meter. And what we found, farmers are feeding their plants with substandard fertilizers. It is universally recommended that the urea must contain 46% nitrogen, but the commercial urea sold in Nepal market only had 36.92% of the nitrogen. And the specified value of the DAP is 80% for nitrogen and 46% for phosphorus. We all know this. But sample we used only had 0.19% of the nitrogen. Do you believe this? And only 17.22% of the phosphorus instead of 46%. So just look at the standard of the fertilizers our farmers are using. I think these fertilizers are just like a stone applied to the agriculture field, and that create no positive impacts rather than degrading our soil quality. And so these findings revealed that the substandard form of fertilizer supplied in your farm and have given rise to the quality issues of the agri inputs that our farmer gets. So knowing about all these things, knowing about the ground zero of our agriculture system, let me summarize what our farmers needs for impactful agriculture system. Needless to say, they need reliable and quality agri inputs like quality seed, reliable irrigation source for achieving the bountiful harvest. And our producer needs support either in the form of subsidy for mechanization and agri inputs, and affordable finance for those youth who have a real passion and potentialities to venture into the commercial farming. If we agriculture technicians guide these producers with quality agri advices on need basis, this will help them to cope with the potential loss of yield from their farming enterprises. And one of the most important thing, we could guarantee the sale of their agriculture produce at fair price on actual time, so they do not have to plow their produces, they do not have to destroy their produces because of not getting fair prices. The farming gives relief to the producers. And to achieve all of these, the things I mentioned, the problems I mentioned, and the anticipation that farmers are expecting, to achieve all these things, the producers will be digitally connected. And this will motivate them for farming as well as help build a resilient agricultural system. So let me introduce Gampower here. And knowing these things, Gampower since 5 years is working to provide the reliable solar irrigation system with affordable and easy financing for the needy and potential farmers, supported with a personalized agricultural advisory. These days, we are establishing a digital agricultural value chain to connect our end users to your market. And all this innovation, we call it yield improvement in a box. With an integrated solution supported by digitization, we are helping farmers to improve their agricultural yield and increase their net income by over 80%. And we use analytics technology in creating valuable, relevant, and trustworthy medium provide farmers with way to improve their lives. This is how our digital solution looks like. The digital solution from Gampower, that is also, we call it Upgrid Bazaar, which is actually a remote platform for creating a real impact. And the Upgrid Bazaar is a digital project management and service delivery platform that uses the state of art of technology and data analytics to track and analyze individual farm level data and combine with the weather data, market data, crop specific databases, generate actionable insights for the farmers. And this will help farmers better maintain the soil health, prepare for extreme weather events, plan and schedule crops to maximize profits, and adopt modern farming and crop management methods to achieve the maximum productivity. And this platform uses the weather data. It collects and analyzes the weather data to derive the localized and relevant insights for the farmers to help anticipate and limit the negative impacts of expected, to limit the negative impacts of unexpected weather events. And it also uses the market data. OGB collects the market data on cost of agricultural inputs, price and demand availability of farm produce, etc., to help farmers plan crop calendar and maximize their profit. And the next innovation we incorporate in this system is the Internet of Things enabled smart meter, included with every solar pump, and also now can be installed separately. This smart meter uses agri sensors to record and send farm data like temperature, pH, NPK, moisture, etc. And other sensors can also be connected on the need basis for the farmers to the, and we harvest the data. We actually harvest the real-time data to our OGB database. And this platform also consists of the crop data. The OGB has an extensively and continuously evolving crop database with information on land preparation, use of agri inputs like seed, irrigation, fertilizer, pest and disease management, storage, etc., to help farmers adopt the best practices for improving the yield. Gampower QC meter, what we feel proud of, is a smart agriculture meter that gathers farming data and operational data of remotely located solar agro-processing systems, solar farms, agriculture farms, from the producer fields. The data generated through the meter is used to generate real-time insights for the farmers that help them to improve their existing farming practices and also optimize the uses of solar water pumping system, as well as also optimize the use of precise use of the agri inputs like fertilizers, water, and etc. So this is the general view of our innovation, smart QC meter. We can mount around 12 sensors, verified sensors that could be mounted to exaggerate the real data from the farms and provide agri advisory to the farmers, as well as provide information of farm to the producers. So the smart meter, it is equipped with different electronic and agriculture sensors. I already mentioned in the previous slide. It collects operational and agriculture data, which is sent to Gampower Cloud database through GSM mobile network. And the digital project management system, Upgrid Bazaar, displays those operational data in near real time And the off-grid bazaar software also tracks and analyzes the farming data to control the operation to send agri advisory triggers in the form of SMS in need basis to the farmers. And our agriculture export team analyzes those near real-time field data and consult the producers about minimizing their risks in agri enterprises. So before installing our system, we collect the baseline data from the interested producers, interested in customers, where we combine this data with continuous farm data collected by sensors mounted with GAMPower QC meter. We propose a crop planning and calendar based on the farmer's data, his atmospheric data, soil data, as well as we consider his economic ability to invest to recommend different crops. And we guide farmers through the personalized static dynamic agri advisories. So sharing the impact so far we have created with all this innovation and provision mentioned in previous slides, GAMPower is able to share the success story of boosting the yield of our end users up to 80% in minimum 3 years of adoption of our systems. And hopefully the upgraded digitalized approach might be much more beneficial to them than only solar pump. So far the projects from GAMPower are concentrated, these projects are concentrated in southern belt of Nepal, the Tarai belt of Nepal, because the solar water pumping system have much more applicability in this area. And the digital platform of GAMPower developed as a result of our interest to measure the impacts of these projects and could be installed in other regions of Nepal except solar water pumps. The positive implications among our end users are because of the appropriate personalized agri advisory through digital monitoring of near real-time field data of the farm. We have developed a strong database to recommend our farmers with localized agri advisory based on the geographic, atmospheric, and soil data. The producers are being informed about the weather complexities, disease, and pest outbreak based on the temperature and humidity data. And this has helped to mitigate the probable reduction in the yield among our producers. As we regularly connect our farmers, we have the information about their production status, what they are producing at, which time they will be harvesting that product, and which we are using to improve the market access. This information, we are connecting the information of those producers to the market and access to create access and linkage for achieving the new state of economic resilience. This digitized approach from GAMPower has helped producers in many ways. We are hopeful to upgrade this version of creating more impacts in the coming days too. And this digitized platform is increasing an access a producer to get an easy access to the data, agriculture market, and be connected with key stakeholders in farming and agri supply chain. The advisory sent from the export teams has obviously increased the agriculture literacy of those producers. And in the future, they will be loaded with a bunch of information. And this will make the producer capable to make self-decision to achieve the targeted yield. Not only this, our near real-time monitoring of the field data and precise agri advisory has enabled the sustainable groundwater use by mitigating the depletion of aquifer to mitigate the potential climate hazards in the future. And the tracking of the status of agri inputs in soil and atmosphere will enable producer to use the agri inputs precisely. And this will help to mitigate the eutrophication in water bodies, preserve the biodiversity because of the less use of pesticides, and ensures the economic use of agri inputs as well. So in the future, our technology will have a positive impacts among the smallholder farmers who are living below $1.7 per day. This is the per capita income of the smallholder farmers at this time in Nepal. And this is expected to reduce the workload of the female in agriculture. Actually, our technology has to address the problem that females are facing at this stage in Nepal. So our technology is expected to reduce the workload of female in agriculture, who bears the major responsibility of the farms and who do not have land ownership. This digital solution is expected to provide information to producers and connect them with the potential agri input suppliers and market by breaking the chain of middlemen and increasing their agricultural literacy. This must be the verge of my presentation. Up to now, I shared my thoughts on ground reality of Nepalese agriculture, talking about digitization. I talked about the low-cost, high-impact technologies that could have real impact in our future agriculture and shared some of the experiences and achievements out of the deployment of this digital solution from Gampower. And I would have made it more complex. I would have made this presentation more complex because as digitalization seems to be more advanced to talk, but I must stand on the ground reality and tell about the technology that suits our smallholder and that is attainable by our smallholder farmers. I might have talked about, rather than talking about drone farming, satellite farming, robot farming, though these things look so fancy to talk, but though they have huge, also they have huge impacts in large scale farms, in case of Nepal, if they could be brought in Nepal, but let us begin from the small and let us talk small. Let us talk about the low cost technologies that could have high impact among the producers in Nepal. And talking about the future from national perspective, by 2050, Nepal's population is expected to be 36 million with half of the population living in the rural area. That means half of the population will be living in the urban area. And the resulting land fragmentation and because of the plotting and you know the common system we practice in Nepal and the number of smallholder farms are obviously to increase. There will be rise in national food demand in the coming years. And at this time, there will be a challenge to cope with the climate change also. And everyone will be urging for sustainable resource use for achieving the environment and agricultural resilience. I see agriculture sector more glamorous and risk mitigated to address the problems mentioned earlier by the use of different digital solutions. The data-driven solution enabled by big data that will enable producer to make rapid decisions to mitigate the potential risks of agriculture. And the artificial intelligence and machine learning today has proven to be a boon to achieve those tasks where human will fail to implement them accurately. The blockchain technology, this will help to make agriculture more transparent and fair. The producer will have an easy access to the market and there will be no intervention of middlemen. So the consumer and producer will buy their goods in one transaction. We do not have to depend upon the 5 to 6 transactions where the main producer gets 50 to 300% lower than what we consumer pay. And Internet of Things, these sensors enables us to make the real-time decision based on the real-time field data to secure the production, we advise farmer accordingly. And the aggregation of the mined data in cloud server, we actually collect all this data collected by the IoT sensor. We collect all the market-related data and we store it in a cloud server, accessible to all, and this will help to make a better decision for future agriculture for all the stakeholders involved in agriculture or in the agricultural value chain. The proliferation of digital technologies, it will play a major role in agriculture. A digital transformation, it can unlock the potential for smallholder farmers across Nepal to increase their incomes. And it is an opportunity for farmers to be visible, to be empowered, and to engage directly with their customers. Lastly, I would like to quote, agriculture is the fertile ground for digitization, for making a difference to build a resilient agriculture and food system in Nepal. So I would love to hear a question from you people. Please, the host team, consider only the official questions. That could be discussed officially in this forum. Informal questions could be discussed in the informal session. So thank you for your patience. Thank you for hearing me. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. I'm done.